thank you so much for being here. You were in the corner for a couple of your guys. I think they all won, right?
Yeah, good, yeah, both the guys won. So that's good. Norbert in spectacular fashion. Doesn't surprise me. Shipman a little bit more of a struggle, but he's up against Charlie Ward. It's not going to be an easy fight for anybody. So he played it very tactical and got the win. So I'm happy for both of them.
Well, back to you, because you have a big fight coming up, Mike. Why did you sign to fight Goiti Yamauchi? Because he's number five. Why not with the other guys? And he's a tough task. I don't mean it like yeah. that. But how did you come with Goiti?
We were going to go with Jason Jackson, but I believe he's next in line for the title. So he was like, I'd prefer to wait for this fight. Completely makes sense. And I know he's not scared of anybody. So it's not a case of, let me duck. It's a case of, it makes more sense to me. Instead of having another fight that can potentially knock me back, I'm already in line for the title. I can sit back, wait for these two to finish, and then take the winner of the fight. So it was supposed to be that. And then I think the next person down was going to be Yamaguchi.
So what do you know about him? And why does this fight excite you?
It excites me because he's a specialist. He's exceptional in a specific area. And I'm exceptional in a completely different area. And this is what MMA is about. It's about those two styles crossing, which one's going to be, you know, the most effective on the day. So it's just a great fight. And you know, he came off a win, spectacular win against Gracie, and showcased his boxing style as well. So yeah, he's an amazing athlete.
Last one for you, Mike, because I know you're not going to be the main event of that night. What do you want to do after that? Because I want to look a little bit forward, because
party.
People love you in Europe. They are building cards around you. You are the big ticket seller. Do you think after that you're going to come back to Europe again, Mike?
It depends. You never know where the fight's going to take you, where the fight game's going to take you. And I don't care too much about stuff. I've never cared about stuff like that. Because I always say, if I'm on the card, I'm the main event. If I'm on the card, you're remembering what I'm doing. I don't care where I'm on the bill, I'm the main event.
Please come to Amsterdam soon, man.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Michael, your teammate Norbert Aveni Jr. coming back from a long layoff with injury. He put on an absolutely flawless performance out there. Just how special is this kid?
Like, every time somebody asks me, don't tell him though, because so it's... But every time somebody asks me, like, who's the next special thing in your gym? I always mention him. Who's the most well-rounded? I always mention him. You wouldn't even, just from what you just saw, even today, you wouldn't believe he's got an amazing wrestling background. That he was raised in wrestling, because his striking is unbelievable. So yeah, he's scary all around, and even his jiu-jitsu and stuff. You guys haven't seen anything yet, so I'm looking forward to that growth.
What is it specific? You know, what is it that makes him so special?
He's, I don't want to big him up too much. He's just special. but to be fair, he lives for it. He went through a difficult time, and I think it's always hard for anybody to kind of come from layoffs, but mentally it can screw with you as well. He had a massive knee injury, and it can kind of mess with you mentally. And as young as he is, he's very mature. I got him under my wing, and I could just see amazing things for him.
Yeah, your other teammate Mike Shipman was fighting Charlie Ward, a solid win there tonight. Charlie seemed to be having some fun showboating a little bit in the second round. Did you, as a showman yourself, did you appreciate that?
100%. He's in his home crowd. It's down to him to kind of get the people going, and I think in turn I throw the energy to the crowd throws it back to me. So sometimes you need that. So, you know, he's like, he taunts a little bit, they get loud, and it makes you want to, you know, go push a bit harder. But it's obviously a difficult night for him.
We most recently saw you in bare knuckle against Mike Perry. How do you reflect on that experience? Obviously, you didn't come away with the win. Do you regret taking that fight at all?
No, not at all. Fun fight, fun night. Everyone's, you know, controversial about the decision. I don't really care. For me, I'll go and do it. I'm a combat artist. You know, give me a challenge. I'm going to figure it out. I'm going to go in there. Very different. Very, very different. Every graze causes an effect. Whereas here, you kind of have to hit clean. But it's almost like you have elbows for hands. Everything you put out there is damaging. And I had to really tough it out that night. And I enjoyed it.
Would you take another bare knuckle fight?
100%, yes. Bellator is cool. I'm staying here for now, but 100% yes, I would.
Obviously, the welterweight title is being contested tonight between Amosov and Storley. Who do you see winning that later on?
It's a difficult one. In all honesty, I'm a massive, massive fan of Amosov. His style, striking, wrestling ability. I love the way he puts it together. obviously now experience being in the cage with Storley, seeing their last fight, with the addition of the extra two rounds, I think potentially Storley can steal it. If it goes the same and then there's two extra rounds, then I think it's leaning in more Storley's way. But, and obviously with the time off, with what he had to go through, we don't know how of an effect that is for anybody. So hopefully, you know, it hasn't changed anything. He's still the amazing athlete that we all know. And it's just going to be a spectacular night.
Last one for me. KSI has been training in London Shoe Fighters. Is he good? Is he a good boxer? How good is he?
He's, for me, you know what it is? A lot of people get hung up on the YouTube title. I don't care where you come from, because there's fighters that were ex-rugby players. There's fighters that were mechanics. There's fighters that were, but we just didn't know. So I only know you from MMA now. So we don't criticize them. But because we knew their background, we see their background, oh, they're just a YouTuber. I don't care where you come from, as long as you put the work in the gym and you take it seriously as a combat athlete, you're a combat athlete to me. And this guy's in the gym every single day, putting in work. And you see the transformation in his body and what he's done for himself. And obviously that last fight, he's improving, getting better. He's a combat athlete.